So now we come to the first problem of Unit 2. This time, instead of dealing with orbits, we have a pendulum, and we want to create expressions for its position, velocity, and acceleration. As always, we've given you some code to help you out. Here you can see the time step, the magnitude of the acceleration due to gravity, and the length of the pendulum, which is just the length of the string to which the bob of the pendulum is attached. What we're asking you to do is to first fill in this definition for the acceleration of the pendulum, showing how it depends on the position of the weight. Now, if you think about the way that a pendulum swings, you can imagine that if we extended the trajectory, we would get a circle. So position is the length of this curved path. The next thing that you need to do is to fill in this function called symplectic Euler, in which, logically, you will use the symplectic Euler method to calculate both distance and velocity. So to help you out a little bit, here is a refresher on what the symplectic Euler method says. Another important piece of information, if you're not super comfortable with physics stuff, is Newton's second law right here, showing the relationship between force, mass, and acceleration. So looking back at our code, you can see that we've created empty arrays for you for position and for velocity. It's up to you to fill these arrays in, including the initial conditions. So remember, you'll need to initialize x and v by saying x of 0 and v of 0 equals something that you're going to figure out. I'm going to give you a few hints, though. You can see that we've created this constant called num initial conditions and set it equal to 50. What you're really doing overall in this problem is looking at 50 different pendulums, which each have different initial values for x and v. Now, to give you a visual of what this looks like, I'm going to show you the final plot that you'll get with this program. So here's the set of graphs that you should get as your final result if the program is working correctly. We're going to ignore these top two graphs for now. Let's focus on this bottom plot. This is showing velocity on the vertical axis and position on the horizontal axis. Now, if we look at the top two graphs, we can see that this green set of points right here corresponds to what's happening at time zero. So this green ellipse down here is showing the set of initial conditions for the 50 different pendulums that we're looking at. So this green ellipse is kind of like a snapshot of what's happening to all of these different pendulums at time zero. The way that I want you to figure out how to set the values for each pendulum, for x and for v, is to just think about this ellipse. Now, in Unit 1, you learned a lot about orbits, and you'll actually be able to use some of that knowledge in this problem. Knowing that this green shape is an ellipse, we can see that its major axis right here lies along the line v equals 0, and its minor axis lies along this line x equals 2. Now, the half length of the major axis is 0.25, so I guess actually, even though it looks like the major axis here, it's really the minor axis if these two sets of axes had the same scales applied to them. Either way, this rightmost point on the ellipse corresponds to x equals 2.25, and the leftmost point corresponds to x equals 1.75. In terms of v, we have values ranging from negative 2 down here to 2 up here. So think about what equations for x and v you would need to create an ellipse with these dimensions. That will be how you set the initial conditions for x and v. I think this is a really interesting problem, so I hope you enjoy doing it. Good luck!